New York City, Liberty Island, UNATCO headquarters.
I'll take you back to the city after you check in with Manderly.
Okay.
Welcome back. Your mission was a success. Just about the only bright side of the operation, unfortunately. Report to Manderly for a briefing.
Mr. Jack?
Yeah?
The prisoners on level 3 are a sensitive matter. Leave the interrogations to Mr. Simons. You are authorized to receive your orders from Joseph Manderly, after which you will return to the helipad.
Simons. You guys from D.C.? What agency?
Please proceed to Manderly's office. We will expect to see you shortly.
Don't listen to what they're saying about the shootout in the park and Hell's Kitchen. You had other priorities.
Hey, man, I helped.
Do not question the prisoners yourself.
Interesting.
We will be waiting. I do not understand the reason for your delay.
Okay, bro.
They still have some terrorists downstairs. Ones you didn't kill in the statue.
We have read this.
Don't worry about what the guys are saying about Hell's Kitchen.
Hey, man, what the... I'm gonna take your soda. I did help with the shootout. I guess I didn't kill a lot of them, but I didn't wound one, maybe two. Pretty sure maybe I killed one.
He said he's busy, but to wait outside his office.
Okay.
I'd watch what I say about Mex around Anna Navarra.
Is he saying that because I told her off the other day? Righteous Angels, Perspectives on UNATCO, by Wendy White. Chapter 2, The New Seraphim. As the giddiness that greeted the new millennium faded to grim apathy, in the face of plague, famine, and the inevitable waves of national convulsions that followed in their wake, the United Nations found itself increasingly outmoded and unable to cope with the worldwide rise in terrorism. Tensions between the affluent, walled away within private enclaves, and those less fortunate escalated rapidly as basic medical care facilities collapsed under the weight of each new outbreak. The very persuasiveness of the net fractured communities into smaller and smaller special interest groups, and as local police grew increasingly ineffectual and access to deadlier weaponry more commonplace, conflicts spilled over national borders and onto the streets of major urban cities. The United Nations was forced to admit that their own military was both outmoded and unequipped to deal with these threats, so a new organization was required. UNATCO, an army of seraphim, divinely charged to mete out impartial justice with burning wings and flaming swords. Okay, weird. Ooh, there's a thing in there. Who's this guy?
Oh, hello, ma'am. I don't think we formally met. I'm Chet.
Hello, Chet.
Good to have you on the team.
Okay.
Hey, you're Paul's sister, right? I bet you're as good as he is.
Okay. Image, Millennium Magazine. Millennium, the future of business. Bob Page. Will Aquinas change the world? Experts debate. World of unlimited bandwidth. Resurgence in world terrorism. Barcode. Okay, Bob Page is also augmented, it seems. President Philip Meade. Oh, new news. Stopping Terror, a new perspective on freedom. When one maniac can wipe out a city of 20 million with a microbe developed in his basement, A new approach to law enforcement becomes necessary. Every citizen of the world must be placed under surveillance. That means skycams at every intersection, computer-mediated analysis of every phone call, email, and snail mail, and a purely electronic economy in which every transaction is recorded and data mined for suspicious activity. We are close to achieving this goal. Some would say that human liberty has been compromised, but the reality is just the opposite. As surveillance expands, people become free from danger, free to walk alone at night, free to work in a safe place, and free to buy any legal product or service without the threat of fraud. One day, every man and woman will quietly earn credits, purchase items for quiet homes on quiet streets, have cookouts with neighbors and strangers alike, and sleep with doors and windows wide open. If that isn't the tranquil dream of every free civilization throughout history, what is? Anna Navarre, Agent UNATCO. That's an interesting point of view. Like, if you completely take away people's liberties, if you have an extremely authoritarian government that controls everything, sure, there's less crime, but is it really a free society? That's interesting. Terrorism, war without fronts. How do we fight an underground threat, one with no defined territory, base, or often known leader? We look to military history. The casebook example of how to manage civil unrest is the Hamlet evaluation system, developed by the United States military during its occupation of South Vietnam in the 20th century. Since population centers in that country contained both communist rebels and loyal citizens, the towns were ranked on a scale from 1 to 5, 5 being the safest. The monthly reports of local commanders, useful in Vietnam for maintaining contour maps of ideology concentration, have provided many components of the UNATCO sector field report. The modern UDU, UNATCO developed unit, has been modeled on the CAP, Combined Action Platoon, deployed in Vietnam, a 15-man rifle squad responsible for a single hamlet. CAP-protected villages typically earned a 2.95 head score compared to a 1.6 average in the same region. CAP units performed in many mission roles, but they primarily worked with indigenous police to strengthen ideological ties. Like CAP units, UNATCO teams are primarily concerned with building safe communities. Joseph Manderley, Director, UNATCO. Know your enemy, Templars. There is some debate as to whether the Templars should be considered a terrorist organization because they do not employ the typical tools of terrorism. But make no mistake, the Templars are just as dangerous as any other group that might use guns and bombs to intimidate the free citizens of a country. Only the Templars wield blackmail and extortion as their weapons. Supposedly the direct descendant of a so-called secret society with its roots in the medieval Crusades, the present-day Templars are mainly concerned with increasing their own bank accounts in elaborately illegal financial manipulations that have left entire markets collapsed in their wake. The Templars are currently classified as inactive after being successfully diminished by a combined UNATCO-Interpol raid on their Paris headquarters in 2051. However, several key Templar figures are still at large, and many attempt to reform the organization under a new designation. Know your enemy, X-51. Little is known about X-51 aside from their involvement in all manner of illegal research, much of it proscribed by worldwide concords over the last 50 years. Computer profiling shows a high likelihood that X-51 was responsible for the SoCal disaster that submerged much of Southern California, though the exact nature of the experiment that led to the tragedy is still unknown. Wait, Southern California has been submerged? That's crazy. Little other information is available on the overall objective of X-51, if any exists. X-51 is believed to be led by Gary Savage, a scientist previously employed by the United States government for a variety of black projects until he disappeared under mysterious circumstances several years ago. All agents are advised to be vigilant for any indications as to the whereabouts of Savage or other members of X-51 and report them immediately to their operator or immediate superior. Daedalus Global Node. Wait, Daedalus, we've heard that name before. We saw it mentioned in that MJ-12 secret outpost thing in the sewers. It was about hacking, remember? Interesting. Also, Gary Savage.
Agent Navarro was gunning her motors about Castle Clinton. I guess you cleaned the place out.
Gary Savage, I think, was the guy mentioned in the beginning of the game in the intro. ACD, Bionic Man. Jaime Reyes. To J.C. Denton. Subject, congrats. Congrats on surviving your first mission, Noxterin. I know it's all part of the job, but I'm glad to see you back in one piece, more or less, anyways. If you get this message before I get a chance to see you in person, then get your ass down here so I can patch you up. By the way, I hear a few things from up top, and I get the impression that they were definitely taking advantage of this NSF attack to evaluate your performance. So far, everyone seems to be ecstatic. Well, everyone except for Gunther, but he's got his own problems. Keep it up, but keep an eye out too. I get the impression sometimes that everyone here has their own agenda. Jaime. Paul Denton. To J.C. Denton. Subject, watch your back. I don't have much time, so I'm gonna cut this short. They're going to tell you a lot of things about what went on today, and it's probably all going to get pinned on me. I've got my reasons, but I can't go into them right now. Not over the net. But you've got to trust me that there are reasons. Maybe I can point you in the right direction. Tap a few computers and see what you come up with. Try Manderley's computer if you can risk it. Password is Nightkiller. Does everyone know Manderley's password? You might also check Navarez, but I don't have her password. Cold woman, be careful around her. And for that matter, everyone else. P. Should we do that? Should we snoop? I mean, how are you gonna snoop Manderley's computer? Are you supposed to do that in front of him? That would be weird.
I was here first.
Mr. Manderley is in a meeting, JC. You'll have to wait.
I was told to report for a debriefing.
A debriefing? Do not worry. I will state in my report that I was satisfied with your performance.
You'll have to wait a minute. Mr. Manderley is...
Just fire the arrogant son of a bitch.
I wasn't exaggerating. He's our best agent.
We don't need him. More are on the way.
He knows nothing.
I think he does. You should never have sent him to Hong Kong.
Let's be sensible. We have to look at the whole record.
Look, I understand. He was your pet project, but it's out of my hands. Now that the shipment's been lost.
I know. I will comply with the order.
That's all I ask. Carry on. I'm going downstairs to interrogate the prisoners.
I cannot wait forever. He will see you when he's ready.
We're talking about Paul. That's interesting.
Carry on, Agent.
Agent Denton, at your service.
Denton. Yes, I hear you're turning out to be quite an asset to the Coalition.
Doing my best, sir. Forgive me, but I do not believe I know your name.
We aren't ready for an introduction yet. No, it's not time. Just keep your nose to the pavement. You will be well rewarded. Trust me. You aren't needed, Agent.
I am next.
Ugh.
You know what?
I am losing valuable time.
You know what? No. We should follow him.
Welcome aboard, Agent. I'm Shannon. It's a pleasure to meet you. You're friends with Jaime, right? He sure did a good job with the casualties tonight. I've heard that Manderly is more than satisfied with your performance so far.
Manderly says only senior staff members can interview the prisoners.
I don't think you're supposed to be down here, Agent.
We're looking to you to set an example. I have one question.
They already asked. I don't know.
One must admire a man who can keep a secret because he has value. What you know more than others makes money and gives you a measure of power.
You Walton Simons? You think I could be bribed?
Margaret Forsyth, under NSF protection in Queens. Your son Richard, attending Bronx Science. You see, I have a few relevant facts myself. Care to make a trade?
You wouldn't dare.
I'll give you 2 seconds to decide. Get out of here, Denton. This is none of your business.
I can sum it all up in one word. Self-reliance. That's what we stand for.
How about you tell me where that shipment is being taken?
UNATCO assumes that people are incapable of protecting themselves, and therefore should submit to surveillance and intimidation by an outside force. We won't do it.
Time's up. Where is the NSF taking the Ambrosia?
They asked me already. I don't know.
Need I remind you that in the case of a national emergency, FEMA has a list of 6 million Americans who will be transported to detention centers? Your tabloids call it RX-84.
Yeah, including the President, Congress, and the Supreme Court.
In my position, I find it very easy to add names to that list.
Go to hell.
The governments of the world believe the average citizen should not face the threats of terrorism alone.
We don't need your help. The technology exists today for an individual to protect his property against explosives, firearms, surveillance, intrusion, contamination.
Get the hell out of here, Denton.
350 million fortresses is not my idea of the land of the free.
It's better than one big fortress constructed by a corrupt government against its people.
The United States government has had emergency power since World War II. We've never left a state of war.
Speak for yourself. The federal government is just responding to a threat.
A government should be about more than self-perpetuation.
You will confess, by the way. I don't like to dirty my hands with that sort of thing, but you will confess.
It's simple numbers. Big companies pay like 2% tax. Well, you and me, we pay like 50. It's the tax code that makes sure big bureaucracy gets bigger and people have no power.
You have an assignment in New York, Agent. I expect you to follow orders.
Let's get back to the subject of the missing vaccine.
All taxes are social engineering. That's always been their real purpose.
I'm not going to sit here and let you badmouth the greatest democracy the world has ever known.
What happens is that politicians get money from big companies, so all the social engineering is for making big companies. Like I said, it's simple numbers.
Certain intellectual properties, aside from the quantities of vaccine, concern me deeply. Has the NSF made any attempt at reverse engineering?
Leave me alone.
A government shouldn't have to occupy its own country with troops. If there wasn't organized oppression, there wouldn't be organized resistance, and what you call terrorism would not exist.
If you wanted to save people, you could have unloaded the whole shipment in Manhattan, or the airlift.
You said it yourself. Secrets are power.
You can lock me up, but you can't lock up the truth.
We have less civilized ways of making you talk.
telling the truth.
I am a patient man.
Ask me if I care.
But not that patient.
What the? Bro, what are you doing?
You saw nothing, Ditton. Report to Manderly. Your turn. See what you can find out in Manhattan.
This dude is a savage.
I won't say anything, but I think you should go.
Yeah, I think so too. Okay, we'll talk to him later. Let's go talk to Manderly.
I am losing valuable time.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, JC. Come in. Clerical task first. Your op bonus is split between the Castle Clinton and warehouse objectives, 500 each. You get the full 1,000 plus 200 for how you handle the hostage situation in the Battery Park subway station. Good work across the board.
Thank you, sir. Who was that you were meeting with?
Politics, bureaucracy, mismanagement. JC, I've got some bad news. The mission failed.
I would have taken out that JoJo punk, but he wasn't even in the warehouse.
Never mind that. He slipped out before you even got to New York.
What about the shipment?
I'm just going to say it straight, JC. Your brother screwed up. We got nothing, and he's taking the heat this time. The Coalition is letting him go.
What went wrong?
We don't know. He hasn't reported back. The rest of the strike force says he lost his nerve.
I think he was trying to avoid casualties. In Hell's Kitchen, instead of clips for the troops, he was issuing tear gas.
Whatever the case, now it's your turn. We've got one more chance to retake that shipment.
Has it been located?
Get any equipment you need from Carter, then take the chopper back to the city. We know they plan to put the Ambrosia on a plane, but we don't know which airfield.
Where should I start?
If I were the NSF, I'd be moving it through the subways, the abandoned parts of the infrastructure.
I'll check out the subways.
I have been waiting for 20 minutes.
Sorry, Anna. What is it?
A new assignment. I think Agent Denton should handle the assassination.
Is there a problem? You lost your appetite?
I think she will make a good assassin. The courtyard of Castle Clinton was a graveyard.
It's kind of an exercise, you mean?
We should give her the opportunity.
Our pilot Jock is waiting for you at the helipad.
I am anxious to see one of the experimental agents perform.
You aren't alone, Anna.
Okay. The Castle Clinton thing was an accident. UNATCO Handbook. UNATCO and the police. In carrying out their duties, UNATCO agents often work with other law enforcement agencies. We remain a small elite organization. Until our ranks expand, we must rely on the cooperation of local police, governments, intelligence agencies, and corporate security divisions. Always be courteous when requesting information or filing an extradition request. As our jurisdiction widens, we will inevitably experience conflicts with some local officials. Do not resort to unnecessary intimidation in these situations, and report any problems to the appropriate UNATCO liaison. Above all, an international law enforcement body requires the respect and support of all participating nations. I let the door hit me on the way out.
Good luck, JC.
Thanks. Okay, we should go downstairs, talk to our friends, talk to Jaime, to Alex, and report to San Carlos.
I'd like to know what the feds are doing down in the cell block.
I'd like to know that too.
I took a few hits tonight. The doc had to operate.
Well, get well soon, soldier.
Yes, sir. I will. Dr. Reyes said they took the bullet out, but I still feel it in my stomach. It's like a piece of ice. They also said I lost my spleen.
Damn, dude.
Looks pretty bad down here.
Keeps getting worse, too. It must be raining bullets out there.
The NSF aren't kidding around. How you holding up?
Fine. I lost one of the privates because a refrigeration unit went down. That's always hard.
You got a lot on your hands. Don't beat yourself up over faulty equipment.
By the way, we aren't in such shambles that we can't spare a few medkits. Check the storage closet.
Thanks for talking to my friend. He admires you. I knew what I was getting into when I joined up.
You certainly made an impression on the troops tonight. Years of training and you're still all thumbs.
Medical Management of Biological Casualties Handbook.
It's a living.
U.S. Army... U.S. Army Medical Research Institute of Infectious Diseases. In addition to the detrimental health effects of the targeted population, biological warfare agents would likely cause significant impacts on the medical care system. Massive numbers of patients and demands for intensive care would overwhelm medical resources. Special medications or vaccines not generally available in standard pharmaceutical stocks would be required. Medical care providers and laboratory personnel might need added protection, and autopsy and interment of remains could present hazards not commonly dealt with. Read this. We shouldn't snoop on Jaime's computer.
I need a vacation.
Oh wait, let's get healed up. You know what? I think this wasn't about a drone. This was about an actual helicopter. Maybe the black helicopter that we're using to travel. The one Jock is flying. Speculative fiction, research trade show. Calvin. Who's Calvin? No idea. Stupid doors. Wait. What was Anna doing down here?
They still have some terrorists downstairs. Ones you didn't kill in the statue.
Yep, not anymore.
Agent Denton, marvelous. In addition to an accuracy weapon modification, I've got some 7.62mm rounds and a couple of multi-tools.
Mr. Carter, I can't tell you how great it is to be a part of UNATCO. You should have seen the fighting in Castle Clinton.
Yeah?
I cleaned the place out.
Dude.
Went in shooting, huh? I guess that's what this agency is known for.
I never thought I'd see this much action in one mission.
In my day, international peacekeepers were citizens first and soldiers second. You can forget about that extra ammo. I'm only going to give you the multi-tools. I think you should concentrate more on mission objectives and less on the enemy body count.
I didn't mean to do that. That was a mistake. That is so funny.
They told us to hang tight. Objectives remain, apparently.
Okay, you know what? Let's check our inventory a little. We should have this here. And the accuracy. We need good, better accuracy for this gun. The stealth pistol is gonna be our...
You have your orders for Mr. Manderly.
Yep, I do.
Thank you.
Stealth pistol is gonna be our, like, default weapon. So, that's the one I'm going to be... Oops. Upgrading.
I wouldn't do that if I was you.
UNATCO Handbook. UNATCO and the press. Because UNATCO will often deal with situations that cannot easily be contained, agents may unfortunately need to interact with the press. If you are not trained for such interaction, do not, repeat, do not speak with journalists, regardless of nationality. They are skilled in misdirection and propaganda. Refuse comment. Remember, security procedures are our first line of defense. Secrets are lives. Always refer reporters at crime scenes to UNATCO information officers and fact management teams. Fact management teams. Dude, that's an amazing term.
Just filling out a report on the mop-up operation.
Yep. Damn it, I really shouldn't have gone into the castle kingdom thing. Everyone is talking about it endlessly. It's getting crazy.
Hope this one turns out a little better.
Yep, me too.
Your chopper's ready, Agent.
Thanks.
Those jerks from Washington think they own the place.
Get on the helicopter, Miss Denton. Simons did not appreciate your interference. Please do not keep us waiting.
Let's check the comm one. Maybe there's something there. Oh, there's a multi-tool in here. Janine's bot. Specs and overview. Matsugrava's R118 repair bot. The Matsugrava's R118 is characteristic of all bots in the MG repair line, an autonomous unit capable of a wide range of repair, maintenance, and construction tasks. By default, the R118 is equipped with a Kroya Searchlight 3 Argon laser attached to the standard MG IRL arm, Chang optics and visual processing, a self-recharging bioelectric battery, wireless command control, and 16GB of internal memory for a superior amount of task customization at an affordable price. The bioelectric interface adheres to the same light standard pioneered by MG and adopted by most other companies around the world, allowing all units in the R-line to act as mobile bioelectric rechargers if necessary. Okay, so we can use this to recharge.
Let's go.
Let's go.